Stamped 3D painting. So for this video, I'm going to show you how you could use 3D printing to and some bleach to put cool designs onto your shirt. And if you look on Etsy, there are shirt sleeve stencils that you could use to do this. They're laser cut or CNC'd. But I don't have either of those. I didn't want to buy a Circut because they have a pretty steep subscription program. So for these Celtic knot designs, I just went into TinkerCAD and I used that to design some printed molds or some printed stencils. And when you print these, they have to kind of have a rail on top to hold any loose pieces like this. Otherwise, you're going to have to manually place the pieces down. To do this, you'll need a room with good ventilation, or you could do this out in like a garage or outside. Disposable gloves, t-shirt. And for these, the t-shirt should be at least 50% cotton or more. And these are literally just dollar store t-shirts that I got from where I work. For the molds, or for the stencils, these are 3D printed in TPU. And this is semi-flex. You can do this in rigid. Vegetable spray. So just any spray oil you could get. And a spray bottle with half bleach and half water. You don't want to do it any stronger, otherwise you could actually burn a hole through your clothing. You'll also need scrap cardboard. And I had a couple spare rags here, so have those ready. All that will get washed later. And so, time-wise, this takes about 10 to 20 minutes per, like, kind of design, based on how long you want to let the bleach set and bleach out the clothes. So if I... And so you can see how the design is connected here. When this is done, you'll also need to run this in the washing machine to get the bleach out. When you get these shirts, wash them first. That gets out any extra dyes and loosens up the fibers a little bit. And then you'll have to wash it no matter what after you're done doing this. I've been doing some experiments in bleach dyeing dark colored material. So unlike tie dyeing, where you take a bright or a white shirt and you dye it with colored dye, with bleach you take a dark color and you bleach the color out of it. So you produce a negative color. So I've done some, I've been practicing with some different early experiments. So I actually printed this one up in PLA, and I just tried putting it on, spraying it down with a bleach solution. This is half bleach, half water. That didn't turn out well at all, and it just bleached everything out completely. I got a little better by just basically taking a piece, and this is one of the fidgets I sell. Put it down, and I just sprayed around it, if I could get it right. And spraying around it to produce this effect. So this is better, and it produces kind of a negative design within it. The problem is you really have to kind of seal this against the material you're printing with, you're bleaching. So after these few experiments that were just fails, I rewatched all the videos that I could on how to do bleaching, and they pretty much use like a Circut cutter to make a vinyl stencil that tapes itself onto the fabric. I don't have a Circut, and I just wanted to see if I could do molds with 3D printing, so I tried some other things. Basically I just used the spray and I just sprayed bleach straight onto the piece and just used it like a stamp, which is okay. And you can see some of these results. The problem with that is that you'll have to restamp it two or three times. And I think when I finally got a good result here, I really kind of soaked it and was able to bleach it down like that. So basically in this case, you're basically using a 3D printer to make a stamp. This is TPU, which is bleach proof. And then after this, I started seeing, okay, I still needed some way to seal it. And so I came across the idea of using spray oil. So I did some more experiments. This is a mold, this is a stencil print in Cheetah Tech TPU, so it is semi-flexible. So I actually sprayed the mold, the stencil, with vegetable oil, put it down, used that to seal it against the fabric, masked this area off, not very well, but I masked it off, and then sprayed it inside. And as a result, I got this. Now the spots here are where extra liquid has kind of soaked onto the bar that I had to put here to support it. And so this is just a common pattern that I uploaded and printed in TinkerCAD. So this was a whole lot better. And then I came probably to one of my better ends. So this one, put down, sprayed with vegetable oil, I sprayed the stencil with vegetable oil and then sprayed inside of it with the bleach solution to do this. And so this produced that negative space, and the vegetable oil actually turns to soap when it reacts with bleach, so it doesn't bleach the fabric, it's actually protecting it. And so this worked out better to produce this design, but it was still pretty thin. And also what I did is I just basically used this as a stamp, and I sprayed it offsite with bleach, put it down, and repeated that to do this knot design. And just where it overlapped, there was a little bit of issue. So I like these two different versions where I could either seal the stamp to the fabric like this, or seal the stamp to the stencil to the fabric and spray inside of it. So I do have some dark colored t-shirts, and I'm gonna try next to do that. So to do this, again, you'll need your spray solution, half bleach, half water. And you want to do this over some cardboard, because you don't, and it's just a super light spray. And I'll show you that next. So to prep this, you'll want a rag to do this on. And this is a stencil I printed in TPU. You could do this in rigid as well, but you're going to spray this side, smooth side down, with vegetable oil. And you want just a light coating, so if it's a little thick, you could just tap it down, and you'll want to wear gloves when you do this. And with that, you're going to take it and put it over the spot there. So now that you've placed the stencil over the spot where you're going to spray, press it down. Press it down, make sure it's nice and pressed into it, and we want that oil to go into the fabric. So you'll need a rag ready. Make sure to mask off everything you don't want sprayed. This one-handed, and you're just going to want to do three quick sprays, then quickly dab off everything, and let it dry. And you could always come back and do other sprays to make it darker, but with this, do light passes and dry it really quick and pat it dry really quickly to make sure none of it bleeds through. And we'll give the bleach about 10-15 minutes to soak into the fabric. Some things I found with the stencil is that if you do this, make sure the bottom of the stencil is nice and smooth and flat. If it's kind of oily, has a lot of gaps, it's not going to work real well. So I'm going to pull this one up. So if it's like that, Definitely spray too much. So I could probably iron that and get the reaction to stop right there, but that part's going to be, yeah, so here's the edge of the cardboard. And so it kind of got motion lost here. So light sprays. So right now the bleach is doing its work, but you can see around the edge here that it's parts that weren't masked were bleached. So use some blue tape, really mask that area down if you want to really keep that from happening. So you can see the first result. So I just pulled it up. I'm going to go ahead and try and overlap it a little bit, see if I could continue it on. I'm going to definitely mask this edge better and cover up this whole thing so it doesn't get sprayed again. But you could definitely see the result, and there's a little bit of the spots here again where this part of the mold is crossing, so stencil is crossing. So if you do this, maybe play with this, so I designed the stencil, you could see here it had to overlap because I had to have some way to hold it together. So you'll have to play with your stencil a little bit more. I also chose probably one of the hardest designs here. So this is a common Celtic knot design, but it's probably one of the hardest ones you can actually do for this, just because of the overlap and all the parts that would be out on their own. But you can see the definite proof of concept right here. So I'm going to repeat that. I'm going to slide it down, put it on this edge, and extend this pattern all the way over on that shelf. So I overlapped the stencils, and I tried to get as best as I could, trying to use like this part of the stencil to reference it to the previous design. Just sprayed it and patted it down, so it's going to start. Already looks like did a better job of masking off that edge. So definitely take your time on this and lay it out and see where it goes. So it'll be a couple more minutes, and then I'll show you how that looks. So now I'll go ahead and take the masking off. So give me a view of that, let's see what it looks like. Aha, so that worked real well, except for the lines there. Definitely make sure you mask it off. But I did have a good continuation. And so in a few minutes, I'm going to go ahead and do the other sleeve using this design. In this, I could do it two ways. I could either basically just stamp it on like what I did here. Or I could do a negative, or I could do kind of a space like this. Actually, let's see here. I think actually I'll probably go with this, even though I don't quite know. I do kind of like that if I could just fix that little banding right there. So yeah, definitely watch your masking. Take your time and get that masked out correctly. So when I mask this up, get a good shot here. So what I found is if you overlap it here and spray it and then go on, you're going to have a really bright spot here. So you can actually take this and cover up that one section and use that as your overlap for the next part. And just kind of tease the cardboard in just a little bit so it's covering that. And so now it's set so I can spray all that in. So when I pulled the masking and the stencil off, you could see here I got a nice clean line. And you can see that the bleach is already doing its work, so it's only been a couple minutes. I just refilled the bleach ball, so the bleach might be a little bit stronger. But yeah, using the vegetable oil, definitely be not super heavy, but definitely give it a good healthy coating. Definitely helps get the nice clean lines going around. So I'll go ahead and repeat that here. And then put the shirt up and see where it goes. I'm kind of thinking of maybe putting something in the center. I'm kind of debating that right now. But right now, this is going great. When you're done with this, definitely you could fix it by either putting in cold water or hydrogen peroxide to fix the reaction, get it to stop. You don't want to let it go too long, because this will actually eat through the fabric. But yeah, this is great. And I do have some other shirt colors, like red and blue. So I'll have to try those next. So I'll do it with red afterwards, and might try a few different designs. I'll have to see. So take some time to practice this. Maybe if you could have some scrap fabric, like I just use an old bed sheet. And a couple spots here, that's where I've overlapped the stencil, so it's put a little extra oil into that, so you can play with that. But already this has left a nice pattern using this stencil. So I'll do the last sleeve here with this stencil to produce those really sharp lines. So overall, for my first time actually doing it on actual shirts that I've gotten for this, give myself a 9 out of 10. Sleeve on the red one definitely turned out a lot better. And the spots here, that'll come out in the wash. That's just extra vegetable oil. So you can see here kind of where if you press too much oil into it, it kind of blocks it all out. But the rest of it will all come out in the wash. So for this part, I'm going to do the same thing I did over here. I'm just going to use these pieces because they look a little better, and I'm just going to make a necklace on the collar of the shirt. So I just laid out my fidgets here to see how they look, but you get the idea that I'll kind of look like that going around. For this one, I'm actually taking one of my fidgets that's pretty inflexible, TPU. And I just sprayed one side of it, and I'm just pressing this down carefully as a stamp. So I just sprayed the one side with bleach, so you'll definitely want one that's nice and smooth on the bottom. If you have something that's too gapped or poorly printed like this, then you probably shouldn't use it. And so I'm just, there was a little bit of misplacement there, but you could already see the effect here, how it's putting that pattern on. And again, you want to put a piece of cardboard underneath and just really kind of press it flat so it goes all the way around. So putting the necklace on, there's a little bit too much bleach here and here, so let me get that to focus. And so it's going to be a little bit globby there, but the other ones look like they're going to come through pretty good. So I'll just keep playing around with that.